Welcome to this course on common misconceptions in chemistry. Chemistry, as you know, is an incredibly fascinating field of study. In simplest terms, chemistry is the study of matter and the changes that take place with the matter. Chemists are the people who not only study matter but also produce new matter by making or producing new substances and transform it into amazing things. You will be surprised to know that chemistry is the most productive of all sciences and impacts almost all facets of our life in one way or the other. If you really want to be successful in chemistry, it is essential that you should have a clarity of its various fundamental concepts. Once you have this clarity, it will help you not only in becoming a good teacher, but also a good researcher. Our vast experience shows that there are many common misconceptions in chemistry, and this course basically is an attempt to help you to get rid of these misconceptions. Let's take an example. We all talk of pH. And how we define pH? We say that pH is equal to minus log concentration of hydrogen ions. This is normally the answer which we provide. Now, pH is a number, but if you look at the right hand side, it is minus log and concentration of hydrogen ion. Concentration of hydrogen ion has units. Now, the problem starts here. You cannot take logarithm of a dimensional quantity. You can take log of a number only. You cannot take log of 100 gram or 100 meter, etc. Therefore, dimensionally, this definition is not correct. And this is a common misconception. As we will show in our this course, that we need to replace hydrogen ion concentration with activity of hydrogen ion. And activity of hydrogen ion is just a number. Similarly, we often talk about equilibrium constant and link equilibrium constant to delta G0 by the relation delta G0 equals minus RT ln K. Again here, you can see delta G0 has the units of energy. RT has also the units of energy. But ln K, again here it's a question of dimension, K cannot have any units, because K is a number, and that is why it should be kept in mind that it will have no units. Only then we will be able to take its logarithm. So these are two very common misconceptions. And like that, there are many misconceptions in entire chemistry, in almost all branches of chemistry, and that is what this course will basically attempt at. We will talk about these misconceptions in detail and remove them and clarify them. And I'm telling you that this course is going to be a unique course in the sense that it will help to build your fundamentals very, very strong. And you will emerge as a better chemist, not only in teaching, but also in research.